السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته أخوي القصير الغالي، أحكي لك المسألة التي تمت هزيمتها بنجاح. هسا عندنا أنا كتبتها كلاميا يعني بالأحمر بالرموز إنه جي يساوي H1 الدايركت برودكت H2 implies إنه جي مود H1 isomorphic H2 اللي هو الكوشنت جروب يعني and جي مود H2 isomorphic H1. أوكي، طبعا أنا طلعت النوتيشن أنا مش فاهمها، أنا خط بينها وبين الدايركت سم، عشان هيك أنا حكيت لك إنه المرة ما فيش أحلى. لا هاي دايركت برودكت، انا رجعت للديفينيشنز، هاي ديفينيشن انا حاطه بحكي لك اتش 1 اند اتش 2 بي سب جروب ليت اتش 1 اند اتش 2 بي سب جروبس اوف ا جروب جي وذ ذا فولوينج بروبرتيز. واحد every element of اتش 1 commutes with any element of اتش 2 ذات از اتش 1 اتش 2 equals اتش 2 اتش 1. اوكي، فور اول اتش 1 belongs to اتش 1 اند اتش 2 belongs to اتش 2 اند 2 every element جي اوف جي can be written uniquely as جي equals اتش 1 اتش 2 where H1 belongs to H1 and H2 belongs to H2. In this case, G is said to be the direct product of H1 and H2. Symbolically, G equals H1 direct product H2. This is important, that H1 intersecting H2 equals singleton E. Since, first, E belongs to H1 and E belongs to H2, since they are subgroups of G. And, if X belongs to H1 intersecting H2, implies x belongs to h1 and x belongs to h2. Okay, now x belongs to g since x belongs to subgroup of g, so it is also in g. Now x equals h1 h2 in unique way as in the definition written uniquely as g equals h1 h2. But we have two ways, x e v x, they must be the same way, so x equals e. Okay, this is important in the definition of direct product, but it's not written here. In Abstract Algebra 1 book, it's written that the intersection is equal to singleton e, but here we have proved it from the definition. I will prove this one, that G is isomorph, G mod H1 isomorph, G mod H2 isomorph H1. This one I will prove it, and the other is exactly the same. The mapping will be H1 H2 to H1. Okay. Now we have phi is a homomorphism, which means equivalently homomorphism plus onto. Homomorphism, you know it. Onto, here its definition. F from A to B is onto, if and only F, for all B belongs to B. Okay, codomain B is called the codomain, A is called the domain. For all B belongs to B, the codomain, the exist A belongs to A, the domain, such that F of A equals B, which is equivalent to F of A equals B equals codomain. F of A is the image of A, which is the range of A. Range equals codomain, then it is onto. Here it is homomorphism. You can check it. It's easy. Onto, obviously it's onto. Take H2, H1, H2, bring mapped to H1. It's obvious that it will be onto. Now we calculate the kernel. I will write here definition of kernel. Kernel phi homomorphism, kernel of homomorphism equals x belongs to G1. Here we have phi from G1 to G2. Okay, two groups. So x belongs to G1 such that phi of x equals identity G2, identity of G2. Okay, this is a subgroup of G1. It can be proven easily. This kernel equals H1 H2 belongs to H1, direct product of H2, such that phi H1 H2 equals E. This is E of G, since we are dealing with the same group in both sides of the mapping. Which element in H1 dive would like to will be mapped to identity? They are elements of H2. Why? Here E dot H2 mapped to E. This element is in H2. So the kernel is H2. Okay? So by first isomorphism theorem, H1 dive product H2 mod H2 H2 the kernel, I mean, is isomorphic to H1. Let's say what is the first isomorphism theorem. We have phi from G1 to G2 homomorphism. Okay. Then phi from G1 to phi G1 is epimorphism. The image of G1 is the range. So if we set the range equals the domain, then it's epimorphism. And this is subgroup of G2. Kernel phi, we will use it. Then isomorphism theorem states that phi from G1 mod ker phi, kernel phi, to phi G1 is isomorphism. Is isomorphism. Is it clear? I wish it's clear. If it's not, you are welcome to ask me again.